You know, HPV, as Dr. Rich mentioned, is a virus. It's a DNA virus, and it's the same virus that causes cervical cancer and also some other cancers in that are associated with women primarily, gynecologic type cancers. However, we now know, and this knowledge kind of developed over the last 20 years, so fairly recently, that HPV, the same exact virus, also causes throat cancer.
Okay.
And what happened was that we started seeing patients who are not smokers, but were getting the cancers that we typically associate with smoking. And oftentimes these patients never smoked or smoked very infrequently, and we found that this virus, in the same type of way that it causes cancers of the cervix, it also causes cancers of the throat. We know also this virus is a sexually transmitted virus, but it's important to point out that many, many people in the U.S. and globally are exposed to HPV. The fact that a small fraction of those patients who get exposure get cancer, we're not really clear on why yet. We know it's more common on men than females, males more commonly in males than females, but we're unclear as to why, given that so many people are exposed, why a small fraction of those people get these tumors.
Okay, so that's work that's yet to be done, but I understand there has been extensive work in creating and developing a vaccine
to
help prevent cancer related to HPV.
Right. So from our perspective, even though we treat cancer, we would much rather see prevention than having to treat cancer. Despite how good our treatments can get, we always want to prevent. And in head and neck cancer, specifically in HPV head and neck cancer, it's one of the few times that we have an opportunity for real prevention. And we call this primary prevention, which means that we can actually prevent cancer arising altogether in the throat. The virus, the HPV vaccine, has evolved over the last 20 years. And it was originally just four strains of HPV that were covered. And it was designed primarily to prevent cervical cancer. And it's done a really great job at preventing those cancers. We've seen over the last 20 years, the incidence or the number of cases of HPV cervical cancer drop in the United States and around the world.
So it's indisputable that this vaccine works.
Absolutely indisputable. And now that as we talk about the newer vaccines and we also expand the people who should be getting it, namely giving it to males, giving it to boys and to males, we expect a significant decline in HPV positive throat cancer.